Homo Bodoensis were believed to be our direct ancestors and would have lived in what is now Ethiopia over 600,000 years ago, with researchers suggesting it replaced two other hominid species that have been known to science for over a century. Scientists said that the epoch is significant because it was when anatomically contemporary humans, Homo sapiens, appeared in Africa and the Neanderthals, known as Homo neanderthalensis, in Europe. However, some paleoanthropologists have described this period as the muddle in the middle because human evolution during this age is poorly understood. During the Middle Pleistocene period, which is 774,000 to 129,000 years ago, in Europe, the Neanderthals emerged, while further east in Asia, their sister group, the Denisovans, also evolved. In southern Africa, there was Homo naledi. Finally, modern humans, Homo sapiens, emerged in Africa around 300,000 years ago, about halfway through the Middle Pleistocene. This tangle of species has been dubbed the muddle in the Middle Pleistocene. The problem is sorting out which fossils belong to which species and thus how widespread and long-lived each species was. There's also the issue of figuring out which species gave rise to which. A new species of extinct human that has been named Homo Bodoensis will describe the majority of Middle Pleistocene humans from Africa and some from Southeast Europe, while many from England will be reclassified as Neanderthals. The species hasn't been identified based on new fossils, but on re-examination of old ones. Why do researchers think there is another species of human, and who exactly is Homo Bodoensis? Homo Bodoensis is the proposed name for fossils of a group of hominins that lived in Africa during a period commonly known as the Middle Pleistocene, but now technically called the Chibanian. The species has been described by Mirana Roxandic at the University of Winnipeg in Canada and her colleagues. It is named for the Bodo cranium, which was found in 1976 at Bododar in the Awash River Valley of Ethiopia. Bodo 1 is a partial cranium of an adult, presumably male individual, preserving the face and the anterior brain case. The cranium is about 600,000 years old. Homo Bodoensis separated from the Eurasian groups before the split of the Eurasian forms into Neanderthals, Denisovans, and possibly other groups. The skull has an enlarged cranium compared to Homo erectus but smaller than Homo sapiens, which suggests it is an intermediate species between them. However, it is not thought to be an ancestor of the Neanderthals or another group known as the Denisovans, as the remains do not share similar features. Before classifying the fossils, they were given various species designations, which were often used in contradictory ways. For example, depending on which studies you read, the Bodo cranium is variously called Homo heidelbergensis or Homo rhodesiensis. Both species are hard to pin down. In addition, researchers said that Homo heidelbergensis was first named after a jawbone found in a gravel pit in Germany in the early 20th century. Then in later decades, many fossils that didn't seem to fit with Neanderthals, modern humans, or our ancestor Homo erectus were lumped in with Homo heidelbergensis. They say that the species was named after a mandible and they never knew what the head and face should look like. Therefore, it has to go. Then there's Homo rhodesiensis, which was first known from a skull uncovered by mining activity in Zambia in the 1920s. The term is sometimes used to indicate a common ancestor of Homo sapiens and Neanderthals, but can also refer to all the hominin lineages represented in the late Pleistocene. But the name is rarely used in either context because of its association with the atrocities committed under British colonial rule in the region of Rhodesia. For these reasons, Roxandic's team writes in the new study, Homo Rhodesiensis has to go. The researchers argue that Homo Bodoensis lived widely throughout Africa for hundreds of thousands of years and suggest that other specimens of this species include Kabwe 1 from Zambia, the Dutu and Ngaloba skulls from Tanzania and the Saldanha cranium from Elandsfontein in South Africa. They say that Homo Bodoensis also have wandered into the Eastern Mediterranean. Roxandic and her colleagues wanted to make sense of the muddle. They argue that all the African fossils previously called Homo heidelbergensis or Homo rhodesiensis should be thought of as one species, Homo bodoensis. This species, they argue, eventually gave rise to us. Meanwhile, they say Homo heidelbergensis fossils found in Europe can all be reclassified as early Neanderthals, making the name redundant, and that fossils from the Eastern Mediterranean that don't quite fit any of the species could represent interbreeding. For the same reason, they believe that the name needs to be abandoned when describing human fossils from East Asia. Mirana says, "We are confident that Homo bodoensis will stick around for a long time, but a new taxon name will live only if other researchers use it." But as always, there is the opposition team. Not everyone is convinced that a new species name is needed. After all, none of these specimens represent lineages that have never been studied before. Stringer is skeptical of the claim that the Bodo cranium is our direct ancestor. In 2019, his team published a study of the evolution of the human face which found that the species the Bodo cranium belonged to had gone down a different evolutionary path to our species. In any case, debate over our evolution is set to continue for the foreseeable future. The history of the hominids is by no means certain. What are your thoughts on this, guys? Let me know in the comment section down below and do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.